Hi, and welcome to another helpful tutorial video from Ship Our Wedding. We help you easily and affordably plan gorgeous DIY events. Today we'll show you how simple it is to set up our plug-in and battery-powered DIY uplighting rentals. As you tell in front of us, we do have our DIY uplighting rentals. These will come one of two ways. Either you will have to plug these in because they will ship not charged. We'll send them to you charged because they do have a built-in battery. What's great about these rentals, that means that you can use them in either traditional or untraditional ways. Inside a venue, a banquet hall, or at your event, these have a stand right here. So you'll see on the back, this is adjustable and the light will adjust up and down, just like that. This one over here has what we call our dust cover on it. All of our lights will ship like this with a dust cover on it. This will protect the light and prevent any damage from happening to it. So right now we're going to show you how we program these, and then afterwards we'll set them up and show you how it looks on some drapery. Here's a close-up of our light. You'll see here at the bottom, this, if you push it in, this will actually lift out, and this will give it a slight angle towards the wall. And if we push it back in, we can adjust that angle. This way the light beam will go up the wall and it'll look really nice. This is where the antenna will come at. We'll have another video where we'll talk about how to control these lights, but for now, we're gonna talk about this. In most situations, the best setting for the lower adjustable bracket is somewhere between the minimum and the maximum, halfway. This will give you the best angle for maximum results for lighting in your event space. This is the main menu. Now, if we move this way on it, you'll see this is where the lights will come out. Once again, we do have this protective sleeve on here, the dust cover. You do not want to take this off your rental. You want to make sure you keep this on the light the whole time it's in your possession. This is the bottom of the unit. You'll see we have our power in, a power switch. You'll see you have your DMX ports, so you can go in and out. This light will ship with what we call PowerCon connectors. These will go in, you'll line up the holes with the edges that you've seen here, you'll twist it into place. When you want to take it out, you'll actually pull this lever back like this, twist it, and then pull out. We're going to line this up in here. Once it's in, we twist it, you'll hear it click. Now it will not pull out. Now if we want to take it out, I need to pull this lever back. Twist it the opposite direction, and it'll come out just like that. Once again, if you're renting our wireless battery charged DIY uplights, then you will not need to plug in the fixture. This is because the light ships to you fully charged. So let's turn on the light. Now that the light is on, you'll operate it with this back menu. If you do not see this menu screen when you first turn on your light fixture, then hit the menu button in the bottom left corner several times until you get to this main menu screen. You'll see in the top right corner, if your light is shipped to you fully charged, it should say 100%. A 100% charge will last longer than 8 hours. We're gonna go through a quick overview of the menu. You can now use the up and down buttons to scroll through the different settings of the light, just like this. We're not going to talk about help. Set. A couple things are important. Your light should be set to these settings, but if not, you might want to double check them. To go through them really quickly, we just hit the enter button. DMX channel should be set to 10. To go back, we hit menu. Go down, 2.4 gigahertz wireless. Enter should be turned on. Then we just keep going down. Infrared should be turned on. We're going to skip the display backlight, LCD close time, fan speed, restore factory settings, and also manual. And that's it for settings. Now let's go into color. So I just scroll to it, I hit enter to select color. So this is where you can select a custom color or a static color. Let's go with static color first. So let's hit enter on this. You'll see we have 33 colors in here. Now if I go up to the ceiling, you'll see this light is projecting a color. This is the most common way to use this light fixture. These are very popular colors, and as we start scrolling through, you'll see now this is a green, this is more of a blue right here. Just go up and down and just hit enter. Once that's set, you can then go to the next light and set that static color as well. While your lights don't have to be set the same color, you can use alternating colors, or you can go through one color the whole room, or if you like, it's only take seconds, you can actually change a color throughout the night using the color value. So let's go back, we're gonna hit the menu button. We're going to go to custom color, hit enter. You'll see it says RGB, W, Y, and U. Those stand for red, green, blue, white, amber, and also purple UV. These are the different colors that we can mix to control the light. So when you see a pink come out, it's actually going to be a mixture of blue. So let's go ahead and bring in some blue, just like that. Let's say we go up this far in the blue, hit enter, and let's go and bring in some red. Because blue and red mixed together will give you a purple color. just like that. Now, if we scroll up to the ceiling, you'll see that we have a purple. So when you're setting one of those 33 color values that are preset into this light, it's actually mixing the different values of red, green, blue, white, amber, and also purple. Remember what these values are, and you can set them individually on every light if you like, or you can go with one of the 33 preset color options. So let's go ahead and hit the back button. Let's hit the back button again. Now we're going to go to sound active. If we hit enter, you'll see as I clap my hands, the speaker is picking up the threshold for where that noise level is at. The light is now changing colors as I clap my hands. So this is how sound active mode works right here. You have a couple different ones. You can go mode 1. You can also go mode 2, 3, 4. There's 4 different sound active modes here. See which one you prefer. I would say sound mode 1 is probably the most popular. So let's back out of that. Next, we're going to go into shows. In the show, you'll see there are a couple settings. So as you start going through here, this is an auto color, an auto fade. Auto fade is really nice dinner or cocktail hour of your event. This is fading really fast right now. So let's go ahead and slow this down. The speed setting is set to 99. So let's go ahead and change the auto fade, hit enter. You'll see that highlighted. We're gonna bring this down, let's say 50, and hit enter. This fade is much more slow now. It's not as sudden. So this will look really nice during, let's say, the dinner or the cocktail hour of an event. You can also make this go more slowly if you like. Besides auto color, auto fade, there's an auto sudden, an auto strobe, and there's also a Wi-Fi mode. We'll have a separate video that covers how to use these lights in Wi-Fi mode. So let's go ahead and hit the back button. And the last setting we're gonna show you is gonna be DMX 512. We're gonna hit enter on this. This is if you want to use this with DMX. Majority of our clients will not be using this with DMX. That's when you hook it up to something else. However, this light can control other lights when you have a DMX setting. We will have a separate video on that as well, on how to control these lights. So our next step is gonna be to plug these in, set these up against some drapery to see how the color looks. And once again, if you reserved our battery powered lights that are fully charged, you will not need to plug them in. You can just simply adjust the lever back here, aim them on a nice angle against your backdrop or your wall to go ahead and light it up. So let's make that happen. If your lights are shipped not charged, you'll have to plug them in. So find the closest outlet and start taking your lights and make sure they're evenly spaced. You might have to use extension cords. A good rule of thumb is to have your lights spaced every 5 feet. Typical venues and event spaces require 20 lights. If your space is a little bit bigger and you're expecting over 300 people, we would recommend 30 lights. Backdrops, we recommend 2 lights on every 10-foot section. Once again, you'll take the light, and if it's not charged, you'll insert the PowerCon connector by twisting it into place. Make sure you adjust the back bracket to the right angle so that color evenly distributes on the space you're trying to light up. Then you will turn on your light. Next, navigate to this setting here to adjust the static color. Use the up and down arrows to select the color of your choice and hit enter. Do this color selection for every light. Here's an example of 4 plugged in DIY uplights on a straight pipe and drape backdrop. We have our static color set to 33, which gives a warm, soft candlelight glow. Here's an example of a slow fade. Once again, if you have our battery powered lights reserved, they will ship fully charged. You'll notice these lights don't have any cords attached to them. Battery powered lights will last approximately 7 hours. Let's look at some photos of recent events that have used this rental in action. Browse Ship Our Wedding more DIY tutorial videos and get started by checking your date's availability. Together, let's help you plan the event you deserve.
Now you know how simple it is to set up our plug-in and battery-powered DIY uplighting rentals. Watch more videos above. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you in our next video.